So in this class we are going to study is the topic is called the mesh analysis. So the other name for the mesh analysis is can be called as the loop analysis, can be called as loop analysis or the Maxwell's current circulating method. So these are the different names we can call as the for the mesh analysis, Maxwell's circulating method. So as already in the previous class we have seen, so this mesh analysis is nothing but is a combination of your KVL and Ohm's law. So that is what it is, a combination of KVL and Ohm's law, and this technique is mostly can be suitable for if the network has more number of series elements and the more number of voltage sources. If for the given circuit, if it has the more number of series elements and the more number of voltage source, then you can prefer to go for the mesh analysis technique in order to solve that any kind of network. Now we're going to see what is the procedural steps you need to follow in order to do the mesh analysis here. The first step we need to follow is for the given network identify the number of loops we need to identify, how many number of loops that given network has to identify. The second point you need to follow, the second step is, so after identifying the loops, assign the current variables and mark the current direction. So this is the second step you need to follow. The third step is, so apply the KVL in each loop and write the currents and express the current in terms of voltages. So this is the third step. So after getting the number of equations from that loops, so after getting that equations, so solve those equations to find currents in each loop. So that will going to give our solution. That is what we need to follow, these four steps in order to apply your mesh analysis for any given network. Now let us consider the network. For example, my network is something like this, my voltage source, and these are my passive elements as present, and this is my another voltage source has been connected like this, and assign this is V1 plus and minus, and this is the second source is plus and minus, and assume R1, R2 and R3 is there. So I need to find, so for this network I have to apply my technique now. So I have to apply my loop analysis technique now. So what is the procedural steps is given? So you, if you follow that, it is very easy to understand now. So the first step is that we need to identify the number of loops here. Number of loops or number of mesh, you can say. Number of mesh you need to identify. So how many number of loop or mesh we have here? So this is one mesh. This is one loop, I can say. This is one loop and this is the one loop. So we have the two loops, loop 1 and loop 2 we have. This is one loop, closer circuit, and this is one loop, this is the another closer circuit. So I have the two loops now in the given network. I have the two loops, so that is what I identified. So next I want to do is that I have to assign the current direction. So what is the current direction I need to assign here? So please carefully listen here. So for this loop, so I will follow my my convention here is, I assume that my current is flowing in clockwise direction. My current is flowing in clockwise direction, that is I1. And my current is flowing in the second loop is clockwise direction. So this is the convention I following here. Suppose if you have any network, if you are considering that the loop has the, for the first loop, whatever the convention we are following, for the remaining loop also the same convention has to follow. It is not like that for first loop it is in clockwise direction and the second loop it is in anti-clockwise direction. So that kind of things should not be done here. In the first loop, what is the convention I am following? This is the clockwise direction. For the second loop also I am following the clockwise direction. Otherwise, if you are convenient with the anti-clockwise direction, then you can follow that one also. If you need, if you want to do that anti-clockwise direction, then that also can be possible. So I will follow the anti-clockwise direction like this, and if I follow the anti-clockwise direction for the first loop, so the same the direction I need to follow for the second one, anti-clockwise direction. So if it is in the clockwise direction, the remaining loops also in the clockwise direction. Otherwise, if you are following for the first loop, assumed that my current circulation is anti-clockwise direction, the remaining loop also you have to follow the same direction. So that is the point you need to remember here. So for my case here, I follow always my loop is the clockwise direction. I always follow, this is my convention, I use it to follow, my loop is in clockwise direction. So after identifying the current variables and assigning the direction, I need to assign the current variable, how to assign the polarity for all the variables I need to do. So this is assign the current variables and mark the current direction. Yes. So and assign the polarity also. Assign the polarity to each element. So this is also comes in the second point here. So once you are identified the loops, you are assigning the current direction and you are also assuming that these are the current I1 and I2. Now after that, again I have to assign the polarity for each and every element. So for the voltage source, it is not required for me. So for the voltage source, it is not required for me to assign the polarity because that polarity has been assigned here. So I need to assign what is the polarity for this R1. So according to this current, so this is the direction of the current. So this is the direction of the current going like this. So I will assign the polarity plus and minus with respect to loop 1. Now this is the current coming in the R2 in this direction, coming the current in R2 in this direction. So this direction. So according to the loop 1, my current polarity for the R2 is plus and minus. Plus and minus. So that is what I assign the polarities with respect to the loop 1. So these are the current polarities I assigned according to the current direction. Now come to the loop 2 here. So this is the direction of the my current, the loop. This is the my direction of the current loop. On the loop 2, this is the direction. Now come to that R3 here. According to R3, so this is the direction of my current. So this is my direction of the current is going like this. So I can take this is my plus and minus. When come to that voltage source here, for this voltage source, this is the current direction. But anyhow, it is the voltage source that polarity has been predefined. So I'm not going to assign any polarity here. Now come back to that R2 element. For the R2 element, with respect to loop 2, we need to see the direction. So R2 element with respect to loop 2, what is the I2 current direction? The I2 current direction is going like this. So I can assign the polarity for R2. With respect to loop 2. This is plus and minus. So this is what I identified the polarity with respect to loop 1 and with respect to loop 2. Please carefully observe what I have done in this network. So this is what my current directions, and these are the my polarities, how it's look like. So taking the point 2, the analysis has been done. Now go to the third point here, apply the KVL at each loop. So apply the KVL at each loop and write the expression I in terms of voltages. So that is what the third part. So to apply the voltage, I will consider the loop 1 here. Loop 1, consider it and apply the KVL. Apply the Kirchhoff's voltage law. Now I will start. So what is the Kirchhoff's voltage law? In a closed circuit, this current, this voltage plus this voltage plus this voltage equal to 0. So that is what I need to write here. So I will start from this point, from the voltage source point. So this is my current direction going like this. So I will take this is minus V1, and this is the current direction coming like this. The entering point for this resistance is plus. So I can, what is the voltage here? This resistor into this I1, if you write, that is going to define our voltage. R1 into I1, that is going to give the voltage drop across this resistor 1. So what is the polarity here? It is start entering my current at the starting point is positive polarity. I will take this is the plus here, and I can write the voltage drop, that is R1 into I1. Now come back to the R2 here. So I am writing this voltage drop here with respect to the first loop. So with respect to first loop, so if you write here drop, then what is in this resistor R2, two currents are flowing here, I1 and I2. So I1 and I2 are the two currents is flowing here. If you see the polarity of these two currents, which are opposing to each other, this is what the current direction. One is coming like this, I1, that this I2 is going like this, okay, fine. Now if you want to write what is the voltage drop here, the difference between these two currents into the R2, if you write, that drop is nothing but the voltage across the R2. So if I am writing the loop 1, with respect to loop 1, if I am writing the voltage drop here, so that is simply I can write I1 minus I2 into R2 equal to 0. So that is what I am writing. Why I am writing like this? Because my current is coming like this. At the starting point with respect to I1 current, with respect to I1 current, my starting point is plus. So I can write I1 plus I1 into R2. So I1 into R2 I can write. But forget about this I1 current. So this is the direction of current with respect to loop 1. But if I write the same expression for the I2 current flowing in this direction, then what is the I2 current flowing in this direction? So if you see here, the I2 current flowing in this direction, the first mid point with respect to the loop 1 is negative. So this is a current direction coming, but with respect to loop 1, the polarity is negative. So that's why I'm writing minus I2 into R2 equal to 0. So it is simple. You can understand that this is the difference of these two current into R2 equal to 0. So this is the equation 1, how I am writing. Now go for the loop 2. Now go for the loop 2 and apply the KVL again. So with respect to, I will start from this point here. So I can start from here. I can write here, this is the R3 into I2. Now come here for the voltage source, I can take plus V2. Now comes to that R2 here. So with respect to the loop 2, so this is my current direction I2, but what about the current direction for I1? It is coming in opposite direction. So I can write the drop at the R2 with respect to the loop 2, that is I2 minus I1 into R2 equal to 0. This is the second equation. So this is how I'm going to write the loop equations by applying this procedural steps here. So once we will get the loop equations, if you solve these two equations, then you are going to get what is I1 and what is I2. So this is what we need to understand the concept here. Now I will take the one more. I will take the one more, one or two different scenarios, and I will tell you how to do that, so that you can understand the different scenarios here. So now my voltage is something like this, and something like this, and something like this is there. Now these two voltages are some quite opposite, something like this. This is my minus and plus, minus and plus. R1, R2 and R3 is there, and you can now, this is what is given to us, and you need to I mark the current direction now for the loop 1 and loop 2. So this is my current direction and clockwise direction I1, and this is the clockwise direction of my current I2, I'm assuming, and this is the sign polarity has been assigned, but here I need to assign plus and minus. With respect to this loop, this is plus and minus. With respect to this loop, this is the plus and minus, and this is plus and minus. So the polarity has been assigned now. This is loop 1 and this is loop 2 we have. Now apply that KVL at the loop 1, and write the equation here, V1 and V2, assume some of these things. Then I can write this is plus V1 minus I1 R1. What about this one? I can write I1 minus I2 into R2 equal to 0. It's the equation 1. Similarly, write for the loop 2 here. So if you start from this point, then R3 into I2 minus, for this is minus V2 plus, if you write for this one with respect to the loop 2, I2 minus I1 into R2 equal to 0. This is what? The second equation. So if you are, after getting that loop 2 and loop 1 equation, solve that, you are going to get the different, what you call the different currents here. So this is how you are going to do. Now we'll go for the second some other scenarios here. Now we'll go for the different scenarios, but now consider the first network here. So this network, it is different from the previous one. The previous one, what we have considered, it only has the voltage sources, but my network has is a combination of voltage and current sources, then how we are going to write apply that mesh analysis for this, and how to going to write the equations. So these are the loop one, and this is loop two we are identified now. Now assign the current direction again here. So assign the current direction, this is assume I1, and assign the current direction here, assume I2. So after assigning the current direction, I can assign the polarity for each and every element with respect to, this is what, with respect to loop 2 and loop 1. So this is what, so this is for this already the current direction is there, no need, and this is already polarity has been assigned, no need to assign the direction now. Now take the loop 1 here, you take the loop 1 and apply that KVL in this loop, write the equation here. I can write minus V1 plus I1 R1 plus, write what is R2 here, it is nothing but I1 minus I2 into R2 equal to 0. So this is the equation we are going to get in this scenario, loop 1. Now come to the loop 2, what is the equation here is, so whenever in the loop 2, if you see, this is the I current is circulating. I is the current which is associated with the loop 2. Associated with loop 2. So I can write here, note, the current source has the current I which is associated with, which is associated with loop 2, with loop 2. So my current I can write directly, I2 is equal to the whatever the current, suppose say Ix is equal to Ix. So this is the equation 2. So in the loop 2, when you are finding the current source, when you are in the loop 2 and finding the current source, no need to apply the KVL here, because this is the current source, means the current is associated with the loop 2. So I can write I2 is directly equal to Ix. Why it is positive or negative? It is a plus Ix I'm writing. Why it is? Because whatever the my current direction I marked is going same with the volt or current source direction. So both are in the same direction. So I can take I2 is equal to plus Ix. This is what? Plus Ix. Can take this plus Ix. This is the equation 2. Once you are getting the equation 1 and equation 2, you can solve, then you will going to get what is I1 and what is I2. Because already I2 is known to us, right? I2 already found. So if substitute this equation here, so you will get what is I1. So that is what the solution for this one. Now come to here, how we are going to do? Same, do the marking here I1, do the marking here I2, assign the polarities, and now for the loop 1, if you see here, it is plus V1 plus I1 R1 plus I1 minus I2 into R2 equal to 0. So equation 1, writing here. Come to the loop 2. For the loop 2, this is the current associated with that. Some Ix current is associated it. And I can take directly whatever the current is. I2 is nothing but I2 is directly the current source. Current, that magnitude. What is that? Ix. But I need to see whether it is a positive or negative polarity, which is, you want to find this one. So this is my assumption of the direction in this direction, but my actual current source direction is going opposite to this one. So these two are in opposite to each, so I can write the minus Ix. So that is what, how we are going to do the analysis for any kind of network. Now take that this network now. Now apply this thing here. So here this is my I1 direction I'm applying, and this is my I2 direction I'm taking here. Plus and minus, plus and minus, plus and minus, plus and minus. I'm writing here. What is the loop 1 current? We can guess it, because for the loop 1 current, this is the current source is associated with your loop 1. So I can take I1 is equal to, it is minus or plus, because this is my direction is going, this is coming opposite, so I can write minus Ix, the current. Now come to the loop 2 here. What is the current that is flowing here? So this is the current direction, and the loop 2, this is the IY, is the current associated with this loop 2 current source, which is associated with the loop 2. So I can take directly I2 is equal to I2. Both are going in opposite direction. This is coming in down, my assumption it is going up. So I can take, this is also minus I2. So this is already I have of finding from this loop. So in if you see any current source or which are associated with any loop, that time there is no need to write any KVL application, KVL equation. You can directly assume, or you can directly take that current source value as a that loop current. So that is the point you need to understand from these different scenarios. Now we'll do some numericals so that you will going to get a very clear idea about what is the loop analysis and how we are going to find the current. So this is the network has been given, and they are asking to find what is the loop current. So I need to find what is the loop current here and here. So that is what the question is given to us. So this is my loop has been identified, and I am marking the loop or in the current circulating in clockwise direction. So this is my marking here. Now I'm assigning the current directions here, current directions like this, and the polarities also has been assigned. Now after this, this is the loop one, and this is my loop two. So take the loop one and apply the KVL here. Apply the KVL. So what is this? Start from this point. From this point to start. So I can write minus 12 plus 6 into I1 plus I1 minus I2 into this 4 ohm. So this is what I'm writing. This is equation 1. So now go for the loop 2 now. Loop 2, take, and I will start from this point. I will start from this point. So 2i2. What about this source? This is plus 6. Plus 6, and this is i2 minus i1 into 4 equal to 0. This is the equation 1, and this is the equation 2, you can say. So this is can be modified as 3i1 minus 2i2 equal to 1. You can make it as equation 1. This can be modified as 2i1 plus 9i2 equal to minus 3. This is the, you can take as equation 2. So these are the two equations, and I1 and I2 with respect to this, I1 and I2 with respect to two equations and two unknowns, I1 and I2. If you solve this equation, so that you are going to get I1 and I2 equal to 0.13 amperes and minus 0.304 amperes. These are the two currents flowing through this one, these two currents. Once you are getting this I1 and I2, if I ask you to find what is the potential across this resistor, can you do that? Because 6 into this current will give the potential, the voltage drop here. And if you want to find what is power here, you can do that. P is equal to V into I. So like that, and each and every element, you are able to find what is the voltage, currents and power. So those analysis can be done. Now come back to that second network here. So how many loops we have here again? The two loops we have, and I'm assuming the direction in the clockwise direction. This is I1 and I2 I'm taking. This is my plus and minus, plus and minus. This respect to, this is with respect to the second loop, plus and minus. So this is plus and minus I'm taking. Now write for the loop 1 equation. What is the equation? I will start from this point and I will write for this closed path. So minus 7 plus 1 into I1 plus I1 minus I2 into 2 ohms. What about this source? This is plus 6 equal to 0. This is the equation 1. So this is the equation 1 and apply the same for the loop to here. So what you are going to get here? I will start from this point, suppose. Then 3I2 plus 4I2 plus 9 minus 6 plus I2 minus I1 into this element, right, to equal to 0. So after getting this equation, if you simplify this equation, we're going to get this one. If you solve the equation 1 and 2, these are the two equations. If you solve two unknown parameters and two equations, so you are going to get I1 and I2. So this is the solution for this network with by applying that loop analysis. And this is the solution we are getting for the this network. We are applying this this loop analysis. So like that, you can do for any number of problems here. So see the one more here. So these are the some typical problems we need to understand again here. So I will take this is my loop 1, loop 2, and my loop 3. If you see here, right here, plus and minus. This is plus and minus with respect to this, this plus and minus, like this you can write. Okay, take the loop 1. Now I will start from this point, so I can write 9 into I1 plus 6. Now come to this one, plus I can write I1 minus I3 into 3 equal to 0, equation 1. Now go for the loop 2 here. Loop 2 here, we'll start from this point, 4 into I2, and what about this element here? I can take 6 into, this is I2 minus I3, because here the current is I2 and I3, so with respect to this, the second loop I'm writing, so I2 minus I3. Now come to this element, this is minus 6 equal to 0. This is the second equation. Now go for the third equation, third loop here. So I will start from this point. 12 I3 plus 3 into I3 minus I1 plus 6 into this one I'm writing now. For this one I'm writing 6 into I3 minus I2 equal to 0. So these are the three equations. We have the three equations and the three unknowns, I1, I2 and I3. If you solve these three equations, you are going to get this I1, I2 and I3. So you do that in your home and we'll go further proceed for the next circuit here now. So again for this circuit also, I need to find what is the loop currents. Loop currents, that is my question now. Loop current need to find here. So I'm assigning the directions here. For the loop 1, this is my I1 current. For the loop 2, this is my I1, I2 current direction. For the loop 3, this is my I3 current directions I'm taking now. Now, for the loop 1, what is the current? Can you guess what is the current here? Because for the loop 1, this is the current source which is associated this one. So I can take directly I1 is equal to this current, but whether it is a positive polarity or negative sign I have to consider. So see, for actually this is going in down direction, my convention is in going opposite to this one. So I can take 2 milliamperes. This is the equation for loop 1. Now can you write what is the equation for the loop 2 here? Loop 2 also has the current volt, current source, which is associated with this one. So I can take directly I2 is equal to same direction, both my convention and the current source direction, I can take plus 4 milliamperes. Now come to that loop 3. So for the loop 3, there is no current sources as there, so I can follow the standard procedure. So for this, I have to assign the conventions, right? Polarities I need to assign. So this is what the polarities. Okay, I will start from this point now. So 6k into I3 minus 3 plus 4k, that is I3 minus I1. Now go to this element, plus 2k into I3 minus I2 equal to 0. This is the equation 1 you can take. So you already know I1 and I2, right? You substitute these two values in this equation. So you're going to get what is I3. So I3 is coming here. It's coming. So this is what the I3 is coming, 1/4.225 milliamperes. So this is the different configurations of different scenarios of network I have shown in all possible ways to how to apply the loop analysis to solve the any kind of networks. Once you will apply the loop analysis, you are able to find what is the currents in the loops. Once you know the currents flowing through the loops, you can easily find what is the voltage drop at each and every element. Once you find voltage and current in each and every element, you can calculate what is the power consumption by the passive elements, what is the power delivered by your active elements. Now we'll see the concept is called a super mesh. In the previous class we have seen the concept, it is called a super node. What is the definition for super node? If the voltage source which is present in between the two non-reference nodes, then that network is called a super network, and that analysis is called that super node analysis. So that is the concept we have seen, right? So when it comes to the super mesh analysis, in the given network, if the current source is present between the two loops or can get mesh, then that is called super mesh. That is called the super mesh. I will explain this statement now. Can you easily understand? Suppose, so my network is something like this. I have my current is there, and this is what I am considering now, something like this. So here if I have the current direction, some current source like this, so V1 plus and minus, V2 plus and minus, R1 and R2 if you have some current IX you can say. So this is called the super for this. If this is loop 1, you can say loop 1, and this is your loop 2. We have in between the two loops, if this current source exists, then it's going to form a super mesh. In between the two loops, if the current sources exist, then that is going to form a super mesh. This is the concept we need to understand here. So how are you going to analyze this type of the super this type of the networks here? So how we going to analyze this network here? So that is the concept we need to understand. So for this, I will follow the loop analysis concept, the standard procedure. So this is my one loop. Current is I1, and for this is my one loop. Current is I2. So this is what you know, and assign the polarities for each and every element I have done now. Now the first step what we are going to do is here is I will going to remove this one. I assume that this part has been excluded now. Excluded. This is what I am excluding this, and I am going to take here as a complete loop this one. So after excluding that, so this is the complete loop can be has. So this is called a super mesh. After excluding that part, this is going to form a super mesh. For this super mesh, I need to write what is the equation. So super mesh, for this I need to write what is the equation. So now take what is the scenario here. So this is my super mesh scenario here. So with respect to this loop, this is the I1 current, and with respect to this loop, this is the I2 current. Remember this concept now. Now I will start from this point. So this is where my this complete element current source, this current source has excluded. Then my scenario is like this. My network scenario is, sorry. Something like this, my scenario now, and V1 plus and minus R1 and R2 and plus and minus V2, but this is my super node analysis I have to do in this. This is the direction of my super node analysis now, but you need to understand this. You need to understand that here, you need to understand here is that, so in this but mass I1 is the current is flowing, in this mass I2 is the current is flowing. So that is what you need to understand now. If I start from this point, so I can write this is minus V1. Now going like this, at this moment this is plus and R1, into what is the current flowing here? Which current? I1 current. Now going here, going like this, because I want to follow the super mesh. So this is going like this, going like this. For here, it is again plus, I will take. At the plus, what is the current flowing through this loop? That is I2. I can take R2 into I2. Come back here, this is, I can write plus V2 equal to 0. This is what the super mesh equation I am trying to write in here. So this is what. Now after getting this one, again I will consider this part. Again I will consider this voltage source here. This voltage source I need to consider. And for this, if you, with respect to this current direction, what is the loop one current and what is the direction of the loop two current? That is I need to see here. So this loop one and loop two current, if you see here the directions, so I will draw this part so that you will very easily understand. So this is what the thing is given to us, right? So this is the IX direction is given. This is what the I1 direction, and this is what your I2 direction is given. You apply the KCL at this point so that you will get your idea, okay? I can apply that KCL. So this is going to give I1. This is entering, these two are leaving. So I can write I1 is equal to I2 plus IX. So simplify this one, you are going to get I1 minus I2 is equal to IX. This is the second equation you are going to get. So if you solve these two equations, you are able to find what is the current I1 and I2. So this is how we are going to do the numerical. So I will take one numerical and I will explain you so that you will understand more effectively here. So take same network, I am going to consider here, same network, but little modification I am doing here. So little bit modification I am doing here. Assume this is 2 volts plus and minus 2 ohms. Assume this is the 2 ampere current is flowing and 3 ohm, and assume minus and plus it is also some 4 volt is there. Assume this one. And for this I need to find the current in loop 1 and loop 2. I need to find the current in loop 1 and loop 2. That is what I need to do. This is plus, this is minus, this is plus and this is minus. So now write the super mesh equation. Now write the super mesh equation here. So this part no exclude here, and write the super mesh equation. This is what my super mesh equation I need to write. Super mesh equation. So start from this point. So minus 2 here, it is plus 2 into I1, come to this element, plus 3 into I2, now come to this element, minus 4 equal to 0. If you do this one, 2 I1 plus 3 I2 equal to 6. This is the equation 1 we are going to get. So after this, I have to consider this part only, this one, right? So this one I have to consider and redraw that part again. This is look like this one. So this is look like this one, right? So this is the I1 current and this is I2 current and this is my 2 amperes current, and again apply the KCL at this point, KCL at this point. So this is current entering, this is the current entering, and this is also the current entering. I can take the current entering, sum of the current entering is equal to, sum of the current entering I1 plus I2 is equal to the current leaving, this is I2. I can write, then I1 minus I2, if you simplify this equation, you are going to get 2 amperes, that is the equation 2. Now we have the equation 1 and equation 2. Now see, two unknown parameters, and we have the two unknown two equation and two unknown parameters. You can able to find what is I1 and I2. You can do this one, right? So this is how we are going to apply the super mesh. We will again see one more question here so that you will have some idea on that. Yeah, this is what the another network I am giving to apply the super node concept here. So why should we have to apply the supernode concept here for this network? Because for this, so this is one loop, loop 1, and this is loop, you can say loop 2, and this is loop 3, right? Now the three loops. But in between these loop 1 and loop 2, there is a current source is there. So that's why for this specific network, you need to apply the super mesh concept. If in between the two net loops, if there is no current source, there is no need to apply the super mesh analysis. You can go with the ordinary mesh analysis that will give the solution. But in this case, again, in between the two loops, we have a current source. So we have to follow the super mesh analysis. So for this, I have to first, I have to identify the current directions. This is I1. Assuming this is I2, and this is what I am assuming, this is I3, and mark the current direction according to these points. According to this point, according to this current, this is the current direction I mark here now. So what I am going to do here is, I will identify the what is the super mesh here. What is the super mesh here? I need to identify that concept here. Now what is the super mesh equation I have to identify here? So if you exclude this part, then this is my super mesh equation, right? So this is my super mesh equation. I have to follow and I have to write the equation now. Okay, so this is my super mesh equation. So I will start from this point and I will write. Okay, I will start from this point and write. So this is, I can say minus 7 volts. Now come to this point here. At this point, this is nothing but I can write 1 ohm into I1 minus I3, isn't it? With respect to this current, with respect to this element in the loop 1, these are the two currents, I1 and I3 is there, so I can take I1 minus I3 here. Now come to this element, after this 3 ohm resistor, I can take 3 ohm resistance. What about the current here? This is nothing but I can take I2 minus I3 because there is a two currents is there here. Now come to this point, I can take it is 1 into I2, so equal to 0. This is the equation 1. So this is the, after simplifying, this is the equation 1 from the super mesh we are going to take. Now only take this part and write, only take this part and write what you are going to get here. So that is what the concept here. You take this part here, it is something like this. This is what I1, this is what I2, and this is my 7 amperes current. Again apply the KCL here, so I can write here I1 minus I2 equal to 7. So this is the second equation I'm writing by considering this part. So this is entering, right? So I think it is minus, because I1 and 7 amperes both are entering and this is leaving. So I1 plus 7 equal to I2, I1 plus 7 equal to I2. So this is what the second equation we are getting. Now we'll take the loop 3 now. Now take the loop 3. So for this loop 3, there is no voltage source in between that. You can go with the standard procedure we have. So I will start from this point here. 2 into I3 plus 3 into I2 minus I3 plus 1 into, for this I'm writing now, 1 into I3 minus I1 equal to 0. So this is the equation we are going to get here. So this is what the simplified equation. You just try this one also. And after getting the equation 1, equation 2 and equation 3, you solve these three equations. So you are able to find what is the loop current 1, 2 and 3. So this is how you are going to apply the super mesh analysis. Remember, if any current source is present in between the two loops, so that time we need to follow the super mesh analysis. Otherwise, you can follow the standard procedure to solve the any kind of network by using this loop analysis technique. So with this, I will conclude this session for today.